Canada is known to have some of the most extreme laws allowing for medical aid in dying. Many dying patients in the country say they are being forced to end their own lives at the urging of medical professionals. What makes Canada's MAiD laws even more extreme is this. In order to be eligible to receive aid in dying substances in Canada, you do not need to have been diagnosed with a fatal or terminal illness. Many Canadians have spoken out in opposition to these laws, saying that it has enabled doctors to essentially force people to be euthanized. And some people who aren't even sick are now more inclined to commit suicide. Joining me now to share more on this is Canadian Alex Schadenberg. He's the executive director of the Euthanasia Prevention Coalition. Alex, thank you so much for joining me today. Talk to me about Canada's medical aid and dying laws. How did they evolve to become so mainstream in your country?
Well, it's actually evolved incredibly quick, Prudence, because we legalized euthanasia under the term medical aid in dying, a term that made everyone feel better. Mm. We legalized that in June of 2016. And in a very short period of time, we've gone from euthanasia, which was originally sold for exceptional purposes, to it becoming pretty mainstream. We're just in February, the Quebec government announces 7% of all deaths in 2022 in Quebec were by euthanasia. So what happened is that there was a court case in 2019, which was never appealed, meaning it was a lower court decision that was never appealed by the government, which struck down the requirement that someone had to have a terminal type condition. So the only thing remaining in the law is that you have to have an irremediable medical condition, an irremediable medical condition. So basically what it's meant is that people with disabilities are really, you know, how would you say, focused on by a law that kills people.
Unbelievable. 7% in Quebec. That's an outstanding number. Can you
share it's the world leader now, sadly.
Right, right. Can you share with me some stories of the people who have sought help because they feel that they're being forced to do this, to commit suicide? What happens to these people?
Well, you see, there's two different points here. The one is, why are people being approved for euthanasia? And the other reason is, why are they asking for it? And this is what the issue comes down to. So they're being approved for it because they have an irremediable medical condition. And there's lots of people with irremediable medical conditions. Consider, you know, most people with a disability would then qualify to be killed under our law. What's happening, though, is that there are also many of these people are living in poverty. So there's been quite a few stories of people living in poverty who have asked for death because they're living in abject poverty, they don't have enough money to eat, etc. And they've seen then medical aid in dying, euthanasia, being killed as a way out of their desperation. So these are deaths of desperation, not deaths by freedom. These are not freedom of autonomy ideology type of deaths. Yeah. And also the issue of homelessness. Homelessness has come right into this issue in a big way because, you know, people who become homeless, if they have a disability, they would qualify for medical aid in dying, and they've been seeking medical aid in dying. And then there's a whole other group of people who have been saying, I'm not able to get medical treatment. I've been trying to get treatment, and because of my condition, I've been unable to get treatment, but I can be approved for medical aid in dying, and they're dying by euthanasia. There's lots of stories like this, and it's very sad. I just had lunch a couple weeks ago with a guy who wants euthanasia for mental illness, and we had lunch together. And now our country's just delayed that until next year. So euthanasia for mental illness won't be allowed until March of 2024. Mm-hmm. None of these euthanasia deaths should be allowed, but you know what I mean. So this is where it's going. And he talks about his hopelessness. He's been homeless for most of the last 8 years. And these are the kind of things people are doing.
Yeah, it's just devastating. And Alex, euthanasia is on the rise in the U.S. too. Talk to me about the states that concern you the most and how are their policies impacting the United States as a whole, as a country?
Right. So you have assisted suicide in the U.S., and the assisted suicide lobby is really pushing to expand it in a big way. So there's quite a few states right now. There's about 14 states right now that have debated an assisted suicide bill to expand it. You already have 10 states that have legalized assisted suicide in the U.S., including California. So the total number of citizens in the U.S. who have access in their state to assisted suicide is about one-third. Mm-hmm. But on top of it, Vermont and Oregon, who had legalized assisted suicide already, have now removed their residency requirements. So now you have a situation where the assisted suicide lobby is pushing to make assisted suicide national. So they've set up an assisted suicide clinic in Oregon already, and there's a doctor there who's done assisted suicides of people in Texas and the East Coast and different places where it's not legal. And you're getting this massive expansion of assisted suicide through many forces, right? One is trying to legalize it in a state, and the other place, of course, is expanding it where it's legal already. They're also wanting it to move to euthanasia. You know, the assisted suicide lobby only went for assisted suicide because Americans weren't willing to support euthanasia. Euthanasia is lethal injection. Assisted suicide is the same thing, but you have to do it to yourself, meaning they give you the drugs, you have to take it yourself.
Right.
But the intention and the outcome is all the same. But this is where it's going in the U.S., and we have to stand up against this because it's all sold on a lie. It's all about a lie. They tell you that it's all about your autonomy and your freedom. It's about your choice. But what it's about is giving doctors and, in some states, nurses the right in law to cause your death, to be directly involved in causing your death. I oppose assisted suicide because I oppose killing people.
Well said.
I oppose killing people.
Right.
And I think we have to recognize that if we allow more killing of people, if we continue to allow that line in the sand to be crossed, then, in fact, that affects my life directly also and your life directly also.
Yes.
We're all affected by this.
Right, right. Alex, we have about 30 seconds left, but I wanted to get your thoughts on this final question. As you've mentioned, the National Catholic Register has reported that there are people in Canada who actually favor these laws, people who are seeking medical aid and dying to end their lives if they're disabled, poor, homeless. So how do you reach out to these people? How do you help them see the dignity of their lives, even when things look grim?
Well, we talk to a lot of these people. We have a helpline here in Canada. And we talk to a lot of these people regularly. But the fact of it is most of these people are going through a normal human difficulty. They're going through a physical or a psychological difficulty. They're feeling that their life lacks meaning, purpose, or value. We need to be there for these people. The best way to stop the killing is to be the caring person in their life who tells them this is not necessary. I will be with you. I will help you. People aren't actually choosing death because they're in extreme pain. That's the rare case. I'm not saying it doesn't happen. It's a rare case. It's usually because they feel their life has lost meaning, purpose, or value. These are deaths of despair.
Right.
Remember that. These are
right.
deaths of despair.
But no one is alone, and you're doing a great job of showing people that, especially in some of their darkest moments. Thank you so much for joining us, Alex Schadenberg of the Euthanasia Prevention Coalition.
Thank you so much.